Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Sprint. So in this session of history, we'll be taking up the part 2 of struggle for Indian independence. Okay, so we have seen the part 1, the revolt of 1857 and the establishment of Indian National Congress in 1885, right? So moving on to the part 2, how it continues, the struggle for Indian independence. I hope you have inspired through the revolt of 1857. Now we'll get more inspired through some more events in the part 2. And 3 and 4 and 5. Okay, so now we shall see the actual phases of modern history of India from the establishment of Indian National Congress in 1885 till 1905. This phase is called as moderate phase. So this moderate phase was dominated by moderate leaders like Dadabhai Nauroji, Firoz Shah Mehta, Madan Mohan Malaviya, Gopal Krishna Gokhale. So why it is called moderate phase? Why they are called moderates? Because they don't non-revolutionary path. You have to protest peacefully. Okay, we should not go for revolutionary things. And the next, it was after 1905, it was dominated by extremist leaders like Lal Bal Pal, Lala Lajpat Rai, Balagangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal. Okay, so from 1905 to 1915. So from 1915 to 1947, our hero of our India, that is father of the nation, Gandhiji will dominate. Okay, so let's see what is this. Okay, so moving on to chronology of events. So I may be missing some small events, so I have given, so in order to do this, I have given some chronology of events. So I may not be explaining small things, so that I have given the chronology of events. You can refer this chronology of events so that you will be having a continuity in this series. Okay, while explaining partition of Bengal, it is a very wider event. I cannot explain All India Muslim League has established in 1906. So there may be miscontinuity while I am explaining the actual explanations. So that's why I have given the chronology of events. I'll be reminding all those things while I'm explaining things. Okay, so don't get confused. Continuity is very important in modern India. So moving on to the first event of this part 2 is partition of Bengal and Swadeshi movement launched in 1905, and next is in 1906 All India Muslim League will be established by Aga Khan, the Nawab of Dhaka at that time, okay, to protect Muslim interests in India. This was the first communal group. It was established in India in 1906. Okay, there is Aga Khan Palace also in Pune. Okay, next is a Surat split in 1907. I'll explain this. Next is in 1909, Arya Samaj leaders like Lala Lajpat Rai, Lal Chand and Shadilal will establish the All India Hindu Mahasabha. Okay, protecting the Hindus in India. And next, partition of Bengal will be annulled or removed in 1911 when King George V visits India during time of Lord Harding. He was a Viceroy of India at that time. Okay, so capital from British India, from Bengal, will be shifted to Delhi in 1911. Okay, and next is 1915, All India Hindu Mahasabha was founded by Madan Mohan Malaviya, Lala Lajpat Rai, V.D. Savarkar. And next is 1917, Champaran Satyagraha. 1918, Ahmedabad Mill Strike and Kheda Satyagraha. Now we shall start with our partition of Bengal. This is a very important event in history of India. So partition of Bengal, what do you mean by partition? Dividing it into some parts. So Bengal was partitioned into two parts by the then governor, Viceroy of India at that time, Lord Curzon. Okay, so he stated that the reason was Bengal was very big and for our administrative convenience we want to divide it. But the actual reason was to remove the actual nationalism was growing on from the heart of Bengal itself in India. So to remove the nationalism feeling among Indians, he wanted to divide people on communal basis like Hindus and Muslims. So this was the actual reason for the partition of Bengal by Lord Curzon. But the stated reason was administrative convenience. Okay, so partition, Bengal was partitioned into western side and eastern side. So western side was with dominated by Hindus and eastern side was dominated by Muslims. It also included Assam part, and western side included Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. It was partitioned into two parts. So this raised anger among the INC leaders, that is Indian National Congress leaders, as well as the people in India. So now they wanted to take up an anti-partition movement, and they'll come up in 1905 August. So people will gather in large crowds, okay, at a place called Town Hall in Calcutta after taking holy baths in the river Ganges in Bengal. Okay, clear with this? And Hindus and Muslims, to show their unity, they will be tying up rakhis to each other in this event. Okay, and people will be crying out the slogans like Bande Mataram, okay, protect our Lord Mother. And Rabindranath Tagore, the famous lyricist, he will compose the famous Amar Sonar Bangla. Okay, my Bengal is golden, don't divide it. And later this Amar Sonar Bangla will be becoming the national anthem of India in 1971. Now it is a national anthem of India, Amar Sonar Bangla, composed by Rabindranath Tagore during partition, anti-partition movement of, against the partition of Bengal. Okay, so anti-partition movement, though people were protesting against the British, it was not that successful. So to overcome this failure in the anti-partition movement, next movement will be started by INC. So INC's main concept was to protest frequently against the British to get the independence of India. So they will launch a Swadeshi movement in 1905. Okay, so what is this Swadeshi? Swadeshi means encouraging the Indian made goods and prohibiting foreign made goods. So people were protesting peacefully, they were not encouraging foreign goods. Priests were not performing marriages if foreign goods were involved. Okay, people were not consuming salt if it is foreign made. And some people also opened some Swadeshi stores also. So this Swadeshi movement was very huge success, and it has also moved the British also. Clear with this? So Surat split. So what is this Surat split and how it is related to partition of Bengal? So actually the extremist leaders like Lal Bal Pal, Lala Lajpat Rai, Balagangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal wanted to take this Swadeshi movement outside Bengal to remaining parts of India. As it has become success, it was against the British. Okay, but the moderate leaders, they doesn't want to take it into other parts of India because they thought that it may go revolutionary. Okay, it may go non-violent form, sorry, violent form. Okay, so they will be fighting each other. The extremist leaders want to take this Swadeshi movement outside the Bengal, and moderate leaders were not accepting this. And the extremist leaders were of the opinion that every time there was a president of moderate leader only. Okay, so that's why they'll split, the moderate leaders and extremist leaders will split in the Surat session of INC in 1907. After Raj Bihari Ghosh will be, he is a moderate leader, he will be elected. After his election, both extremists and moderate leaders will split in the Surat session of INC. Clear with this? How they are related to anti-partition movement and Swadeshi movement. And the next important event is Government of India Act 1909. So it is also called as Morley Minto reforms. Minto was the Viceroy of India at that time and Morley was Secretary of State. So they will pass some important legislations. So Minto will introduce separate electorates for Muslims. So I have told now, British wanted to divide people on communal basis, divide and rule policy, so that they will not ask for independence. They will fight within each other. So this was a concept of British. So Minto will introduce separate electorate for Muslims. What is this separate electorate? So leaders of, suppose I some positions are for Muslims in the executive council or legislative council. So some positions of Muslims, they will be chosen by Muslims only, not by any person. So this is called separate electorate for any community. So he was the father of communal electorate or separate electorate in India. He has become, so because he has introduced separate electorate for Muslims, okay. And some more things were, for the first time Satyendranath Sinha has become the first Indian member of Viceroy's Executive Council. This was introduced for the first time, and Indians were given some membership in the Legislative Council because of frequent protests by INC also. Okay, and 1906 we have also seen Muslim League was formed, right, in the chronology of events. So these were some of the important reforms through Government of India Act 1909. It is also called as Morley Minto reforms. So now we shall see the entry of our hero of the nation, that is Gandhiji, into the freedom movement. So Gandhiji was born to Karamchand Gandhi and Putli Bai on 2nd October 1869 at Porbandar of Gujarat. He has completed law in London and he leaves for South Africa for work in 1893. Okay, and in South Africa he will face racial discrimination. First, when he takes first class ticket, he'll be thrown away because he was black, right? So this was racial discrimination. Later he will also see the problems faced by Indians and other countries in South Africa because of racial discrimination and apartheid. So to overcome these problems with the peoples, he will form some group called Natal Indian Congress, NIC, to work for the people of other regions who are living in South Africa, who are facing racial discrimination. He will also start a newspaper called Indian Opinion to communicate his ideas. So, and he establishes Phoenix Ashram, okay, so that these people will gather and conduct a protest against the South African government. And he chose the famous protest called Satyagraha. What do you mean by Satyagraha? Protesting in a peaceful manner and in a non-violent manner, okay, not taking any violent form, that is called Satyagraha. Okay, and he also establishes Phoenix Ashram, we have seen in South Africa, and he was very successful in South Africa to conduct a peaceful protest, that is Satyagraha against the British. And though he wanted to live for only some years, he will stay around 20 plus years, and he will return to India in the year 1915. So when he returns to India in 1915, he'll establish the famous Sabarmati Ashram on the banks of Sabarmati River in Ahmedabad, okay, in Gujarat. So this is the entry of Gandhi into India particularly, and then how he enters into the freedom movement. Actually, there was a Champaran Satyagraha which was going on at a place called Champaran in the present Bihar. So why people were protesting means, the indigo planters, European indigo planters, were forcing the Indian farmers to grow indigo. That is, indigo is a dye actually. It is used for dyeing, it is in blue or purple. It is used to dye textiles. Okay. So indigo, these European planters were forcing the Indian farmers to grow indigo at a certain portion of their land. If I grow, suppose in 1 acre of land, rice, so they were asking every farmer to grow 2/3 of their land as indigo only. So this system was called as Teen Katya system, growing indigo in 2/3 of the land. So these farmers have conducted Champaran protest. So a famous person called Rajkumar Shukla, so hearing about Gandhiji, what he has achieved in South Africa, so he will go and request Gandhiji to take up this protest on behalf of the Champaran people. So Gandhiji will enter into the scene. He will take up Satyagraha, okay, in the year 1970, Champaran Satyagraha, and he will be successful, and the farmers will get some concessions, and there was a committee appointed. So this was the first Satyagraha of Gandhiji in 1917, entering the Indian freedom movement. Though he did not come voluntarily, he was asked by Rajkumar Shukla to enter into the protest against the British. So this was the first Satyagraha against the British. Clear with this? Next is Ahmedabad mill strike. It takes place in 1918. So Ahmedabad, there was a mill, cotton mill. The mill workers was protesting against this mill because of they wanted plague bonus. A plague was attacked. Plague is caused because of rats. Okay, so because of plague attack that place, the people wanted to get a plague bonus to get them treated. Okay, so Gandhiji will again enter into the scene, clear with this, on request of some of the people. Though he was in Gujarat, he will get to know about this scene and he will take up a fast unto death. For the first time, he will go on hunger strike. The mill authorities will come down and they will give the bonus around 35%. Okay, clear with this. The next is Kheda Satyagraha. It will take place in the year 1918, same like Ahmedabad in 1918, mill strike in 1918. So what is this Kheda Satyagraha? So in a Kheda district of Gujarat, the farmers, they were forced to give full revenue though there was drought. What do you mean by drought? There is no water. So if there is no water, there will be less agriculture productivity. So they can't give full revenue collection. So even though there was drought, people were forced to give full revenue to the British. So this angered Gandhiji and he will take up the Satyagraha and he will be successful. And there he will meet our famous Vallabhai Patel during this Kheda Satyagraha. So through this way, Gandhiji enters into the freedom movement. So hope you have learned enough things in these topics. We'll learn more topics in the coming chapters. Thank you.